The new European rocket, Ariane 6, has not yet been launched, but it's already obsolete. One could even say dead on arrival. The successes of Elon Musk's company, SpaceX, are to blame. They're very innovative, set a high pace with their dynamics, and have revolutionized space travel with their reusable rockets, and with a pronounced cost-benefit ratio. The European rocket builders around Ariane Group, on the other hand, are only innovative to a limited extent and have not really had to pay attention to costs. For years, they could act as a risk-averse government agency, affording to rest on their past successes. All they had to do was satisfy the European politicians so that the money boxes would open up. There were, however, several expensive European compromises. For example, where two engine test stands were set up because no agreement could be reached on a single location. The engine tests for the Vulcan 2.1 engine, for instance, are carried out in Lampoldhausen, Germany, and the subsequent engine acceptance tests in Vernon, France. After all, an engine test stand like this only costs tens of millions of euros because, unlike the rocket later on, it's not supposed to take off due to the thrust of 130 tons. The rocket itself also accommodates several compromises. While more and more liquid methane oxygen engines are being developed these days, the Ariane 6 is equipped with a central hydrogen engine, a German speciality. And while SpaceX completely dispenses using solid propellant boosters, the new European launch vehicle has a choice of two or four of them, as this is the core competence of the Italian space industry. The reignitable and cryogenic Vinci upper stage engine, on the other hand, has been in development at the French company Safran since 2003 and was to be originally used on the Ariane 5 ME rocket, which has since been discontinued. For a long time, things looked rosy for European rocket manufacturers, but since the successful maiden flight of Falcon 9 in June 2010 and the first booster landing in December 2015, SpaceX has significantly reduced the cost of a rocket launch. Europe had to react because the very successful Ariane 5 rocket could not withstand this cost pressure. Cost-cutting versus innovation. In December 2014, the ESA Ministerial Council decided to develop Ariane 6, designed to reduce launch costs by around half compared to Ariane 5. But if economic history has taught us one thing, it's that you can't grow innovation by cutting costs. You can optimize a horse-drawn carriage as much as you like, but you can't come close to the innovation of the car. But who had thought? As then, Europe develops a reusable rocket, which had to practice in patience. It was not until December 2020 that the decision was made to start developing a reusable rocket stage called Themis for 2023, which could lead to a reusable European rocket in 2030, or maybe a little later. So, when SpaceX, Blue Origin, and the Chinese are already on the moon with their rockets, about to visit the Red Planet, the Europeans will be at the technology level of 2015. They were just real experts at work. By then, the 60-meter-high and nearly 900-ton Ariane 6 will secure Europe's independent access to space. Its first launch will probably take place at the end of 2022. Then the main stage, fueled by the aforementioned Vulcan 2.1 engine along with the solid propellant boosters, which burn for about 10 minutes, should deliver 5 or 11 tons of payload to a GTO. What do you think about the Ariane 6? Write down your thoughts in the comments. If you like this video, check out our other videos.